What is up? Guess what today is? Leg day. So, I am actually, I think once you're into lifting, you get to a point where workouts that you used to not look forward to or not enjoy doing, you start enjoying. Like, for some people, it might be biceps or arms. You might find arms boring at first. Well, okay, scratch that. Nobody finds arms boring at first, but you might find arms exciting at first, and then later in your lifting, you might find them boring. See, now for me, I used to hate leg day, like despise, like most of you, I assume. But I'd say within the past like month, 2 months, I've honestly really started enjoying leg day and kind of looking forward to it at the same time. I think the biggest motivator for me is just seeing the weight move up. And also seeing myself push myself past failure and more than I did the last week before. I think that's the biggest motivator for me and what keeps me going and looking forward for leg days. So we are going to be squatting today. Heel elevated front back squats. Heel elevated back squats. Again, if some people are wondering, it's more so, I put the plate under my heels just so it activates the quads more. So it's more focused on just quads. And also, if you have bad like ankle mobility, you can also put the plate under your heels and that'll help out with ankle mobility because you don't have to stretch as far. But I don't know. I just saw Sam Solik doing it, and I started doing it like a couple weeks ago. Like a month ago now. Kind of at the beginning of the bulk. And now I just do that ever since. So we're going to start off with hamstrings like we do normally. And I'm going to do curls today. Hamstring curls like I did last time. I just really enjoy them. I love the stretch it feels. I love the burn it gives. And I feel like I can push some heavy ass weight. Also, hamstrings are good to warm up. Warm up with and start with first. Because even when you're doing quad exercises like squats, you're still using your hamstrings. So you might as well do them first, get them warm. Get them ready, then you can go balls to the wall and squats, which is what I'm going to be doing. But what else? For quads, I'm not really sure yet. I might try out, I think it's called a hack squat. I think that's the machine it is. I'm not really sure yet. But otherwise, I'm deciding on if I want to do Bulgarian split squats yet. There's a lot of, you gotta exhaust a lot of energy when you're doing bulks. Obviously there's benefits, helps grow your leg, helps grow your quads really well. But then also I feel that once I do bulks, if I were to do them like first or second exercise, then I have zero energy after that. Like, I just wanna go on the ground, curl up and just cry myself to sleep. So, if I do end up doing bulks, it's probably going to be the last workout. And if anything, I even struggle doing calves after I do bulks. Like, I'm completely shut down. Especially when I do the last set where I go to failure, drop one of the dumbbells, go to failure again, then drop the second dumbbell, then go to failure one more time. Like, the last time I did that, I literally threw up. And then I was done after that workout. I was just sitting over the trash can for like 15 minutes. And then I just went home because I was too sick to do anything after. So we'll see on the bogs. We'll see on the bogs. But shit. Other than that, I'm not sure. We'll have to like I do most workouts, I'm probably just going to decide when I get there what I really want to do. But we're for sure doing squats, for sure doing hammy curls, and then maybe RDLs. Again, we'll see when I get there. But I'm about to destroy this yellow light. Oh my god, I made it? Damn, that thing was yellow for like a solid 4 seconds before I even got there. I made it just in time though, so hopefully shouldn't get be getting pulled over. I'll keep you guys updated though. But otherwise, if you don't see me getting pulled over, I'll see you in the gym when I'm warming up for hamstring curls. Alright, see you guys in there. So I just got done warming up. I needed to stretch a pretty decent amount, I'm not gonna lie. My hammies are still kind of feeling a little tight from the last leg day. They're not as bad as they were like 2 days ago, but I can still feel them a little bit when I'm doing these, so I don't think I'm gonna go as heavy this time. I'll go one notch higher or lower, whatever. Whatever's less weight. I'm still gonna be pushing to failure, as you always should. But I'm not sure how many sets I'm gonna do because whatever, I'm talking too much. Let's just get into set one. Whew. Yeah, so like that's one less notch of weight lower, but I still want the same intensity as last week. It's really all about what type of effort you put forth rather than the weight. That doesn't really matter. As long as you're pushing yourself harder each week, then there's gonna be some crazy muscle growth. Okay, time to put these bad boys to work on a day other than back. So we're gonna be doing some RDLs. Biggest thing on these, I'm gonna just go feet close together, back straight, and then down to about shin, and then go up. But I'm not gonna lock out all the way because I don't really want my glutes to be activated. So if it looks like I'm doing half reps, it's just because I'm focusing on my quads rather than my glute.
Ooh.
That was a tough set. Yeah, I don't know. I'm kind of feeling more lower back than I am hamstrings right now. Which, I mean, in other circumstances I wouldn't be opposed to, but right now I'm just trying to train for hammies and I feel like the over back is just the lower back is just overpowering it right now. I think I'll move on to quads now though. I think honestly it's better to take it easier on the hammies right now because especially in this right one, like I can feel it's a little tender still from last week and I don't want to push myself to injury. Like there's pushing yourself through soreness, but I'm kind of feeling this one creep up a little bit and I've already pulled this one on two different occasions within the same year. It was a year ago actually, around now in football season. But so yeah, I think I'm gonna be done with hamstrings for now and we're gonna move some heavy ass squats. So we're still currently on the road to 275 for our top set for reps. But I'll happily do 265 because last time I squatted, I think I only did 245 for my top set. So we're gonna go up 20 pounds. Right, yeah, 20 pounds and see how it feels. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I was going into this leg day extra motivated, ready to go, but my legs are still wrecked from last week. So we'll see how this goes. I'm not sure what we're gonna do after though yet. Holy shit. That could have been really bad. Yeah, maybe next time when I do my top set, I'll get a spotter because fuck. I think I'm gonna start doing my top set is the heaviest, obviously. And then I'll just go down one more or down whatever for One more set. So I took off the 10. So now we're working with 245. I'm pretty much just gonna go till failure on this. Well, right before failure, because I'm not trying to drop the squat bar here. But after that, I think we're just gonna go ham on extensions, on quad extensions. Whew. Whew. Oh my God, again. How the fuck is that about to happen twice in the same day? Okay, maybe I gotta look at my form. I'm bending too far forward? I don't know. I mean, obviously, it's the only reason I'd be falling forward. Yeah, that whole me stumbling on the squats, that just fucked up my whole set. So obviously I didn't go that close to failure doing those, but that just fucked up my mental. I feel like I'm gonna fall every time I do it now. So we're gonna burn out on some extensions here. Probably like 4 or 5 sets. Because overall, this leg day has been kind of mid. The energy was there at the beginning, but honestly, even when I was doing hamstring curls, I just wasn't feeling it today. So, doesn't matter though. This is gonna suck, but we're gonna get it done. That's the most important part. And that is how you fucking finish a mid-workout. That was the best execution I've had on leg extensions ever. I can definitely feel this is the most excruciating quad pump I think I've ever had. This is even worse than the Bulgarians. So let's check this bad boy out. Let's see what... See what those extensions were cooking up. Oh, geez, okay. Almost fell there. Oh, the timelines are back. Yeah, like I said last time, there's just so much blood flow going on. There's absolutely no lines or anything. They just all fill out. Or I'm just not big enough yet, you know? Gee, that could be it. Well, shit. Here's a pretty good pump. So, all right. Honestly, I think that was a good workout just because of how I finished those leg extensions. If I didn't do those, if I put in even 5% less effort, this would have been a terrible workout, I'm not gonna lie. But we pushed through the mental barrier, which allowed us to push through the physical barrier. And we went fucking after it. So, it's just a lesson for me and for you guys. Just because you start something and it starts out bad, doesn't mean it's gotta end bad. Sure, you mess up once. Sure, you have a bad set. Sure, you do bad on a test. This is even life advice. But just work your ass off on the next sets, study your ass off for the next test, and boom. The grass is greener on the other side. Hi, who the fuck do I think I am? I ain't no motivational speaker. I'll see you guys in the car. Oh wait, I got calves first. I'm not gonna record it, because it's just like five sets of calves, so. I'll see you guys in the car. Ooh. We made it to the car. It was a treacherous journey on the way down the stairs to get into my locker. And then we hobbled our way out to the car. So we made it, fortunately. But yeah, I'd say today was an okay lift. I feel like you're always gonna have an off day. Not every workout's gonna go as planned. And this, I guess this was just one of them. But yeah, like I said, just, I don't know. I think it's because I was still fatigued. It's literally just because I went so hard the last leg day. I was just still feeling it today. I don't know. Because my hammies were still sore, and I think that was just my overall legs just telling me. You hit that shit last week. You hit that shit good. So, don't be doing that. I know the new tripod's on the way, but can't be breaking yet. I think it's still arriving in a couple days yet. All right, let me hold you while I go around this real quick. Okay. So unfortunately, tonight I didn't get to the gym until a little bit later, so I still have about 800 calories to eat. Again, protein shake, and I think maybe I'll just have like a Pop-Tart, because those are like 400 calories, I'm pretty sure. And then whatever's left, I'll just take with some peanut butter. But so yeah, we'll get to our calories. But yeah, unfortunately, man, my sleep schedule is kind of ass. It's gotten better than it was like 2 weeks ago, but it's still not great. I'm not gonna lie to you guys or to myself. And this is mostly just me talking to myself right now, because my sleep schedule is kind of shit and I need to fix that, but it's tough. It's tough out here. I don't really know. Yeah, wasn't the greatest leg day, but we still did it. We finished off fantastically, though. Those extensions, perfect execution. I burnt out on every last little strand of my mental I had to get those last couple reps in. So, and then we hit six sets of calves. Just on the seated calf machine, just did 10 reps each time. So 60 in total. I mean, nothing crazy, honestly, but you know, still got to get calves in. You can't forget them. You can't forget them. But shit. Other than that, I think this is going to be a shorter car chat. Because, let's see. I don't think I have anything else really to add. What are we going to be hitting tomorrow? What are we going to hit tomorrow? We could do back. We probably should do back. I might do back and buys. Yeah, because I think I'll do back and buys tomorrow, then chest and tries the next day. And then maybe like shoulders and forearms. We could maybe do that. I've never tried that before though. So it might be fun, or it might be absolutely horrible. I guess we'll find out. So yeah, we'll do back and buys tomorrow, chest and tries the next day, and shoulders and forearms after that. Then hopefully, we should be fully recovered from today's leg day, so I can actually hit some decent squats and actually push myself and not fucking fall on my face when I'm trying to go down on my, what, like sixth rep, I think it was. Because, yeah, after that, like I said, my mental was just down the toilet. I felt like I was falling every rep after that, so I kind of just had to end it there. But I think that's going to wrap it up for today. I'll see you guys on back and buys tomorrow. Peace out, brother.